common current liability would be an account called Current Maturities of Long-Term Debt. We may have borrowed some money that is eventually due in 20 or 30 years, but in the meantime, there are installments that are due. And those installments of principal that are due within the next year are referred to as the current maturities of long-term debt. So let's pretend that we buy a new warehouse and we pay $15 million for it. We put $5 million down and we finance the other $10 million with a 6% 30-year mortgage. So let's create an amortization schedule for that mortgage. So there's several different ways to figure out what that mortgage payment is. If you have a financial calculator like this one, you would be in the third row, so you'd hit second. TVM, you clear the TVM. That's going to clear the time value menu. And it's a 30-year mortgage, so that would be 360 monthly payments. 30 years times 12 months per year is 360. We said it was a 6% mortgage, so that'd be 6% per year. So we would do 6 divided by 12 equals, and that'll give us our monthly interest rate, our interest rate per period. And we said that we're going to borrow $10 million. So we plug that in as the present value, and then we're going to compute the payment. And it tells us that the payment is $59,955.05. Another way to find the payment is to use Excel. We'll tell Excel we want to find the payment, so we'll do equals PMT, open the parentheses, and then it'll walk us through. It wants to know the rate. It's 0.06 divided by 12. In Excel, we have to use the decimals. On our financial calculator, we just did 6. Here, we're going to do 0.06. So we're going to hit comma. It's going to tell us it wants to know the number of periods. 30 years times 12 months a year is 360 periods. And then it wants to know the present value. The present value is the original balance of the loan, $10 million. And then close the parentheses. And we get the same answer, except Excel spits out a negative number. And what we're going to do is change that to be a positive number when we create our amortization schedule. Okay, let's create the amortization schedule. Now we know what the payment is. How much interest do we owe? Well, if we borrow the money on, say, January 1st, and this payment is due January 31st, we owe 1 month's worth of interest. So we owe 0.06, that's the annual rate, divided by 12, that'll give us the monthly rate, times the balance, which is up here in this cell. So that tells us that we owe $50,000 in interest. We made a payment of almost $60,000, and we only owed $50,000. So what is extra must be applied to principal. So take the total payment, subtract the interest portion, and we're left with the principal portion. Now how much do we owe? We owe the balance from the beginning minus the principal portion we just paid, and that's the new balance. And then all we have to do is copy these cells all the way down, and hopefully when we get to the 360th payment, it's going to show us with a zero balance. How about that? So now we know that we created the correct amortization schedule. So then what do we mean by the current portion of long-term debt? Well, let's pretend it's December 31st, 2017, and we have to make our balance sheet. Well, we know that the total balance due under this loan after that December 31st payment is $9,877,198.83. Some of that is due next year. How much is due next year? The next 12 payments all have principal portions, and if we total all those up from January through December, we get $130,375.28. So that's the current portion, and then the long-term portion is the 9746823.55. So on our balance sheet as of December 31st, 2017, that total mortgage debt of $9,877,199 is broken into two parts. The current portion is the stuff that's due within the next 12 months. And everything beyond that is called the long-term debt. And often we'll include a parenthetical phrase that says long-term debt excluding current portion. And that's all there is to the current portion of long-term debt.